welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be telling you about my favorite thing this month. So no, I know I'm just going to be mentioning products like I did before, like a few months ago. I only mentioned beauty products, but now I'm going to be mentioning things like YouTube and music. So this is what I did last month, and I hope you guys like it. I only have one favorite on YouTube that I want to mention, and that is Make of My Dreams. I remember her videos. I feel like we have similar tastes in makeup brands and videos and stuff, and our channels are pretty similar. So if you like my channel, you would like her. If you like her, you might like me. I definitely love her videos. She makes a lot of things that I like and that I'm interested in, and I really recommend her channel. She has great videos, great content, so definitely check her out. She'll be down in the description below along with everything else I'm mentioning. It'll all be down in the description below. And my favorite song this month is Ariana Grande's God is a Woman. When I first heard the title, I was like, what? I don't know if I'm gonna like this, but I actually really, really like it. It's really catchy, and I just keep listening to it, and I love it. And also, I want to take a moment to appreciate Ariana Grande, like her visuals in her music videos. Her music videos are insane and incredible, and if you haven't watched her music videos, go do that now. I am obsessed. And just check out the song. I love the song. It's amazing. Now on to products. So my first favorite product this month is the MAC Prep and Prime Primer, I guess. It is a perfect base for your makeup. It makes everything glide on smoothly, and it just creates a really nice, smooth, perfect base for the entire day. I really recommend it. It has a nice, creamy consistency, almost like lotion at first, but it sinks into your skin and makes everything perfectly smooth, and it really just perfects your whole makeup look. Anyway, I really like this primer. It really gives me a nice base for my skin, for foundation, and it makes everything glide on very smoothly, and everything looks really nice over it. I mean, what more can I say? It's just really nice base for your makeup, and it really makes your skin smooth. And by the way, I have dry skin, so I don't know if it's good for oily skin, but just so you know, I have dry skin, and I love it. And as you may or may not have noticed, I love getting miniature size things, because either I get it in my Ipsy bag, and that's why it's miniature, or I buy it from Sephora or somewhere, just because I don't know if I'm gonna like it or not, so I like to buy the miniature size. But anyway, this is the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer in the shade of Vanilla, and I've heard Laura Lee talking about this. She used to use it all the time, like every time she did her makeup, and then all of a sudden she's not using it anymore. So I don't know if there's some tea with her and NARS or anything, or maybe she just found a new concealer, but I have been wanting to get this for a while, and they had a little sample size at Sephora, so I thought, hey, I'll just try it. And I am obsessed. It's a very thick concealer, and it has a very rich texture, but I really like it. It is very radiant and very creamy. I'm not using it, I'm not wearing it today, but so I can't really show you. But it does have really nice coverage. It's rich, creamy, radiant. It is a little bit difficult to blend, so sometimes I'll just put it under one eye, and then I'll blend it out and set it, and then I'll do the other eye and blend it out and set it, because sometimes it's a bit difficult to blend if you put it on everywhere and then blend it out one by one, you know? So you kind of have to be fast with it, but it is really pretty, and I think if you have dry skin, you'll really like it. I mean, you'll probably like it if you have oily skin, but it is pretty radiant, so. My next favorite is the ColourPop Bronzer in the Pressed Powder Cheek Bronzer in the shade Private Party. In my last video was my ColourPop haul, and that's when I got this. But it's a really nice bronzer. It does have a lot of kick up and fallout. I don't know if mine was like pressed weirdly or something, but there is like a lot of fallout, which I don't really mind, because it doesn't look powdery, believe it or not. Whenever there's a lot of fallout on stuff like this, it But I've been using this every day, and it has a very beautiful glow to it, and it's just really pretty. I believe it's $8, which is pretty affordable. My next item is also a miniature. This is a Fenty Beauty highlighter. Well, they're called Kilowatt highlighter, and this is in the shade Hustle Baby. I live for this packaging. Everything about it is so aesthetically pleasing. I love the way it feels. It is just plastic, but it feels very smooth. And it has a nice little mirror in it, which is nice. And it has the FB for Fenty Beauty printed in the highlighter. This is one of the most beautiful highlighters in the entire world. It is so pigmented. Like, there is a lot to it. And it comes off on the brush, like, really, really easily. It's a beautiful shade. I think this would be good for so many skin tones. It looks good on my skin tone, and I'm really light. But I think it would also look great on medium and dark, so it's really nice. I picked this up in my Sephora haul video. If you want to check that out, you can do that. And it also came with the little Fenty Glow lip gloss. And I think it is really pretty, but I didn't want to put it in my favorites video because my lips are really thin and lip glosses just don't do a whole lot for me. But it is really beautiful and I really like it. But I think this is so cute. I'm definitely going to be buying some full-size Fenty Beauty highlighters. It is truly one of the most beautiful highlights I've ever used. My next favorite is the ColourPop Super Shop Shadow in the shade Pearlized. Wait, what? Oh, crap. Okay. So the shade is not Pearlized. I keep saying that the shade is Pearlized. Even on Instagram, I said it was Pearlized. No, the formula is their Pearlized formula, but the shade is called Pearly. And this is an eyeshadow that I'm wearing today as a highlighter. And it is so daggum gorgeous. This, I've been using this like every day because it's so beautiful. It is a light shimmery, but it isn't even shimmer. Like, there's not really shimmer or glitter in it. It's mainly just glowy and gorgeous. I mean, I don't know how to describe it. It is literally like a pearl, like a melted pearl. And I use this for like an inner corner highlight. Sometimes I just put it all over my lid, but I always knew that it was meant to be a highlighter. You know what I'm saying? So when I used it on my cheeks, I was like, I knew it. Like, it is so beautiful. So if you want a blinding highlight, then you can also use it as an eyeshadow. I mean, honestly, it's an eyeshadow that you can also use as a highlight. But I don't use it for that. I use it as a highlight that you can use as a shadow. It's so beautiful. I mean, I just can't stop looking at it. Oh, so gorgeous. It's definitely for those with a light complexion, but if you have like a fair, pale face, this would be perfect for you because it's so light, but oh my gosh, it's so beautiful. My next favorite is this ColourPop Fortune Palette. I love ColourPop, honestly. By the way, has anybody else like been really anxious for the Kathleen Lines Zodiac collection with ColourPop to come out? I'm going to buy it like right when it comes out. It is so beautiful. I don't think I'm going to get the whole thing, like the whole set, because I don't have a ton of money and I don't want to blow it on things that I'm not really super interested in. But I'm definitely going to get both of the Supernova Shadows and the palette and one of the highlights. But anyway, on to this palette. So, this is a gorgeous palette. It's such a wearable palette with so many beautiful this is the shade. It is so wearable and perfect. Honestly, this is the only palette you need if you're on vacation or something and you need to take a palette with you. It's perfect. These shades are really pigmented, really beautiful. I used it on my sister and that's when I was like, oh my gosh, this is a beautiful palette, and it's going in my favorites video. My sister is actually the one who bought it for me. She got it for my birthday, and I had been wanting it for a while, she picked it up for me, and I was so excited. She knows me very well, apparently, because it is so beautiful and amazing and gorgeous. So here is the palette close-up. It's like got the most perfect shades in it. Like, look at this. Anyway, so a really great palette. I definitely recommend it for like an everyday palette or a glam palette. It's perfect. I feel like you need it. You know what I mean? If you're gonna get a Colourpop palette, I recommend this one because it has shades that I think anyone can wear and everyone needs. Okay, my next favorite is this Ico London Skinny Liquid Eyeliner in the shade Black. It says precise, smudge-proof, pitch black. So I disagree. It does smudge. I mean, it stays on there, but you can rub it and it will smudge. But I don't touch my eyes, so like when I have makeup on, I don't ever touch my eyes. So, this is gorgeous. I was so afraid of liquid eyeliner, and then I got this, and it's like the least intimidating liquid eyeliner in the entire world. I love felt tips. They're my favorite way to wear liquid eyeliner. I know a lot of people don't like felt tips for some reason, which I don't understand, but this is amazing. The felt tip is very small, so I mean it's not like microscopic, but it's a lot smaller than most felt tips, I think. It is so easy to get the perfect wing. I used to like spend like an hour on one wing, erasing it, fixing it. This, I slap it on, and it's perfect. Today, I wasn't so lucky. I had an off day, so I didn't do a wing because I just wasn't feeling it today, and it just wasn't working out. But anyway, this eyeliner is incredible. It's really pigmented. You don't have to go over it to get full matte black. It is really matte, I think. It's very black. I don't know how else to describe it. It's very smooth and wonderful. I'm definitely going to be repurposing this. This is like the best eyeliner I've ever used. And it is a miniature version, by the way. I got this in my Ipsy bag. I think I got it this month, but it could have been last month. By the way, guys, I really want to tell you something real quick. I canceled my Ipsy subscription and signed up for the BoxyCharm because I have been always envying everyone that had BoxyCharm. I've never been able to afford it, but now I can finally afford it, and I'm so excited. So don't expect Ipsy videos. Start expecting BoxyCharm videos. I'm so, so excited. And anyway, yeah. My last two favorites I got in my Colourpop haul. One of them is this Luxe lipstick. This is the cream Luxe lipstick in the shade Una Moss. Anyway, this is a perfect nude color. I really love it. It's not too light of a nude, but it's not too dark. It's honestly the perfect nude in my opinion. It's a pinky, rosy, but also dusty nude. The packaging, oh my gosh. These lipsticks are only like $6, I think. And they're so creamy, so pigmented. And the packaging is so nice. It has a nice weight to it, but it feels really expensive and nice and luxurious. And they have imprinted stars on the lipstick and on the component. But I think they put so much attention and detail in this, and they aren't charging a lot of money at all. And I think it's incredible. I really recommend their Luxe, their cream Luxe lipsticks. They're really amazing. And this is in the shade Una Moss. And I'm going to have all of these things linked down below if you want to purchase any of them or you just want to look at them. But yeah. And my final favorite is this Colourpop Ultra Satin Lip in the shade Aquarius. This is a collaboration with Kathleen Lights. I also picked this up in my Colourpop haul. This is the perfect nude lip. And I don't like the ultra matte lips, I mean, from Colourpop, because they're so drying in my opinion. But the Ultra Satin Lip gives you a matte satin finish, but it doesn't dry your lips out at all. I'm going to put some of this on really quickly because mine wore out. So this is it. I don't know if you can see it. But anyway, The formula is so buttery and smooth, and it flies on with full pigment, and you don't really need to dip in more than one or two times. For me, I would like to dip in one time because my lips are so thin, but I think it's great. I can't imagine living without it now that I have it. It's so beautiful, so perfect, but the color is honestly perfect. Those are all my July favorites. I hope you like this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I'll have all these things linked down below along with my Instagram, which will also be down in the description, so don't forget to follow me on Instagram. If you have any similar favorites, let me know down in the comments below, and also let me know all of your favorites this month. Don't forget to check out Makeup by Trains. Her channel is awesome, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye! By the way guys, if you want me to do a whole video on the fortune palette, I would definitely do that with pleasure, so just let me know.